In this video, we will be diving into the matrix function in CSS, which defines a homogeneous 2D transformation matrix that consists of 6 parameters. This powerful function can help you manipulate the size, position, and skew of your elements in unique and creative ways. Welcome to our CSS lesson. We have an image tag here that shows an image of a grass field on the browser. Now let's head over to the style sheet. The first parameter of the matrix function is scaleX, which resizes an element along the x-axis. However, be careful not to set this value to 0 or the element will disappear entirely. We can reduce or increase the value of the scaleX. Let's add here the transition to see the smooth effect of the matrix function. Add here transition 5 seconds is all. We can increase here the value. The negative value will affect just the opposite. Next, let's go for the second parameter. This parameter stands for skew y. It squeezes an element along the y-axis. This parameter stands for skew x, which skews an element along the x-axis. The fourth parameter is scale y, which resizes an element along the y-axis. Just like the scale x, setting this value to 0 will make the element disappear. This parameter stands for translate x, and it is used to shift the position of an element along the x-axis. The positive value will move the element rightward, and the negative value will move the element leftward. The last parameter of the matrix function represents the translate y, and it is used to shift the position of an element along the y-axis. The positive value will move the element downward, and the negative value will move the element upward. And that's it for today's video on the matrix function in CSS. In our next video, we will be taking a look at how to calculate rotations using the matrix function and matrix 3D function. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more exciting CSS tutorials, and I'll see you in the next one.